The European Central Bank is raising interest rates. Here is ECB President Lagarde.
The Governing Council decided today to raise the three key ECB interest rates by 75 basis points. The Governing Council also decided to change the terms and conditions of the third series of targeted long-term refinancing operations known as TLTRO III.
In this video, I'll explain what it all means. Why is the ECB raising interest rates? The ECB is responsible for price stability in the euro area. It defines price stability as an annual inflation of 2%. But since the summer of 2021, inflation has exploded far above the 2% target. In September of 2022, inflation was 9.9%.
Not great, Bob!
So what is the ECB doing about it? It has raised two key interest rates. The ECB pays the deposit facility rate on money that banks have deposited at the ECB. That's similar to the interest rate you receive on your savings account. Banks can also borrow money from the ECB for a short period. These 7-day loans are called main refinancing operations. The main refinancing operations rate is the interest rate that the ECB receives on these loans. The ECB has increased the deposit facility rate and the main refinancing operations rate already 3 times in 2022. Before these rate hikes, the deposit facility rate had been negative since 2014. And for past rate hikes, we even have to go back to the year 2011. As of 2 November 2022, the deposit facility rate will be 1.5% and the main refinancing operations rate will be 2%. How much money will the ECB pay to banks or receive from banks? To answer that question, we need to look at the balance sheet of the ECB. The ECB has a balance sheet of almost 8.8 trillion euro or 8,800 billion euro. At 4.6 trillion euro, the deposits of banks in the deposit facility make up a little more than half of the ECB's liabilities. I didn't forget to include the main refinancing operations, but these loans are less than 4 billion euro, so you cannot see them on the asset side of the balance sheet. How much will the ECB pay to banks? 4.6 trillion deposits times a deposit facility rate of 1.5% means that the ECB will pay 69 billion euro to banks.
Nice.
The ECB will actually pay a little more because banks also have something called minimum reserves at the ECB. And by the end of 2022, the ECB will also pay the deposit facility rate on these minimum reserves before it paid the main refinancing operations rate.
The Governing Council also decided to change the terms and conditions of the third series of targeted long-term refinancing operations known as TLTRO III.
So TLTRO III are 3-year loans made by the ECB to commercial banks, and they offered these loans between the end of 2019 and the end of 2021. And what was special about these 3-year loans is that banks had to pay a negative interest rate to the ECB. So in fact, they could borrow money from the ECB and pay back less than they borrowed in the first place. And you can ask, why did they do that? Well, if you look at the inflation chart, you can see that at the time when the TLTRO loans were initiated, the inflation was below the 2% target of the ECB. But now that inflation is far above the 2% target, the ECB has decided that these negative rates on the TLTRO loans is no longer justified. And so they have decided to increase the interest rate for the remainder of the TLTRO period to the deposit facility rate. For banks that have outstanding TLTRO loans and also deposits in the deposit facility, the ECB has made it possible to repay the TLTRO III loans early. This will have the effect that both the assets and the liabilities of the ECB go down, and so this will shrink the balance sheet of the ECB. So to recap, the ECB has increased the main refinancing operations rate to 2% and the deposit facility rate to 1.50%. The ECB will pay the deposit facility rate on the deposits and minimum reserves of banks, and it will receive the deposit facility rate on the TLTRO III loans of banks. Taking into account the interest that the ECB pays on the deposit facility and the minimum reserve, and the interest it receives from the TLTRO loans, in 1 year, the ECB should be paying 41 billion euro to banks at the current level of the deposit facility rate. If you are Christine Lagarde and you want to improve your communication, I suggest you read my book, Bankers Are People Too, where I explain how banks and central banks work using cartoons and also a lot of balance sheets, but especially lots of stories about banks and central banks. I have focused on the technical details of higher interest rates and also the TLTRO loans, but of course, since the ECB is responsible for price stability, the question is, will it actually help to reduce inflation? And I did an entire video on inflation in Europe, not just in the euro area, but also in countries with other central banks than the ECB. And to be honest, it doesn't look very promising. So here's a slide that shows the increase in inflation and the central bank interest rate. And so you can see that in certain central European countries like the Czech Republic and Poland, the central bank has already increased interest rates a lot more than the ECB. But you can still see that there is no correlation between the central bank interest rate and the change in inflation in those countries. And also from that previous video, you can see what is causing the different inflation rates between countries is mostly the energy intensity of the economy. So if an economy needs more energy to produce a euro of economic output, then the inflation in that country tends to be higher. And this has nothing to do with deposits, facilities, or TLTROs. If you want to learn more about the European Central Bank or European banks in general, please subscribe to this channel. Thanks for watching.